Let's say you are rehearsing for an important virtual presentation. What if you had a personal presentation coach who observed your body language as you presented and shared feedback with you, complete with photos of you doing things right and not doing right as well? What if the coach alerted you every time you used a filler word, repetitive word, and even sensitive phrase, and suggested alternative phrases so that you can improve your presentation effectiveness? What if the coach told you where in your presentation you were talking too fast or too slow, and where your pitch has been monotonous? Now think about how effective that rehearsal would be and what kind of a difference it makes to your personal confidence when you make the actual presentation. Now, PowerPoint for Web makes it all possible with its new and updated artificial intelligence-based tool called Rehearse with Coach option. Let me show you a quick demonstration of this wonderful tool and the kind of difference it makes to your presentation rehearsals. Let's jump right in. Let's say this is the slide deck I want to rehearse. The first thing you do is to save your presentation onto OneDrive and open with PowerPoint for Web. Once you get into PowerPoint Online, you log in with your Microsoft 365 credentials and open the deck, and this is how the interface would look. Next, you go to Slideshow tab in PowerPoint ribbon, then go to this option called Rehearse with Coach, click on the drop-down menu and check this option called Show Body Language Feedback. Then click on Rehearse with Coach and the slideshow opens up. Here you have a welcome message. It says, as you rehearse, we will give you feedback about how you are presenting. At the end, you will see a numerical summary and your suggestions. I'm going to click on Start Rehearsing. And let's see what kind of feedback I get regarding my body language. Here you can see I have the webcam showing my face. Now I'm going to get closer to webcam and see what kind of feedback I get here. So this is me way too close, and it says move farther away from the screen. Now I have gone back and it says move closer to the screen. Now when I come over here, it says that is the spot. Now, I'm going to put something between me and the webcam, and let us see if PowerPoint is able to catch that. Now, you can see that I have my hand obstructing, and it says, keep the area in front of your face clear. Isn't it interesting? What if I looked away from the webcam somewhere else, like say this? It says, face the camera to show engagement with your audience. Now, let's go to the next slide. Now, let me present my three-step circular process, you guys, and let us hope everybody is fine. Now, you see, I used the word you guys. It might be a sensitive one, so you shouldn't be using it. So that is what is shown here. Now, let me present my first step in the process. I'm going to use a certain word repeatedly. Let me say, this one is so excellent. This is step one, and the colors used are excellent, and even the pointer to the colors are excellent. And as I click, I have an excellent animation coming. And as I go to the third step, there is another excellent placement of the marker. Now, I've used the word excellent way too much, and it is also showing that I am now looking at my slide instead of looking into the webcam, and therefore I need to engage with the audience, so that therefore I need to look into the webcam rather than looking into my slides. It's one of the common mistakes many presenters make, and I'm able to overcome that because of this presenter coach. Now, it also said that I need to try varying the pitch of my talk, and this is a very important thing. Let me show that a little bit later, and how the pitch can be a very important thing to note. It also said, good pitch variation, keep it up, when I actually add my inflection. Now, let me go to the next slide, and here I'm going to increase the pace of my talk. Here we have three different options, and I have three different options here. The first option is this one, and you can see that we have the first option and it obviously failed. And let us go to the second option and let us see what kind of things happen when you try it. There is another failure, and let us see the final way in which I use the third option, and that has opened up and it's a successful response. Now, you would see in the graph towards the end the difference in pace. So PowerPoint will tell me if I have gone too fast. Let me go to the next slide. Here is a slide about electrical engineering.
Let me read this in a monotonous voice. Electrical engineering is an engineering discipline concerned with the study, design, and application of equipment, devices. So it says, try avoid reading the slides, summarize your key points. And this is another aspect about the originality of your presentation. If you read what is there already on the slide, PowerPoint catches it immediately and alerts you to change the words. PowerPoint doesn't have any objection to you using some short phrases, like when you read your title or subtitle. The same way when I go to the next slide, and if I read some of these numbers, like say 41, 29, 60, 60, 52, etc., you can see that there is no alert. And that is because when you present a chart slide or a number-based slide, it is considered a good practice to read some of the key numbers. So you will not find any alert for that. So PowerPoint is intelligent enough to find what is good and what is not. Now, let us say I've finished my presentation. I'm going to hit escape and let us see what happens. I get my rehearsal report immediately, and there are some very interesting observations made by Microsoft. First, let us go to body language. There are three areas under which the feedback is given. The first one is about eye contact. Let me click on the drop-down menu. You can see that this was the instance where I was facing away, and this was the instance where I was facing into the camera. Then we have the next one about clear view. Here I had an obstructed view, and here I have a good clear view. Then about the distance, here I was too close, and this is good. And the best part about this report is there are hyperlinks to the best practices. So when I click on this, you can see that it takes me to Microsoft's article and that specific section about body language and what are the recommendations and where I have deviated. So let me get back to the presentation deck again. Let me go to the first point here. I rehearsed 5 slides and this is the time spent. Let us see the filler words used. I seem to have used the word way too many times. Next, we have this observation about inclusiveness. I use the phrase you guys. It might offend some people. A better alternative is to use you. And as far as repetitive language is concerned, you might have noticed that I used the word excellent way too many times and PowerPoint promptly caught that problem. Then let us go here and PowerPoint has calculated that my pace is 134 words per minute. According to Microsoft, studies have shown that the ideal pace for you to talk is between 100 and 160 words. If you talk too fast, you might sound nervous. If you talk too slow, you might sound unprepared. So you need to keep your pace between 100 and 160. Of course, there are exceptions. There are some people who can talk really fast and yet be clear, and there are people who talk very slow and yet sound confused. The best part about this artificial intelligence-based tool is Microsoft learns your speech patterns over time as you use Rehearse with Coach option. And if it finds that you are clear even at higher pace, then it will stop alerting you as being too fast. Now, this is average pace over time. You can see that I've been able to manage my pace between 100 and 150 words. And here is a small portion where my speed was way too much. And that was intentional. And PowerPoint promptly found that. Then let us go to speech refinements option. You can see that in slide 2, I used this phrase which said, I actually add my inflection. Microsoft suggests that it is sufficient for me to say I add my inflection. And then when I go here, I have a report about my pitch. You can see that there was a point where I was monotonous and this is the area. And later on, when I read the definition about electrical engineering, I sounded monotonous and that is caught here as well. And finally, when I go to the originality, you can see, try to avoid simply reading the slide. And PowerPoint has given me the list of slides where I have made the mistake of just reading from the slide. The only bummer is there is no way for you to save this report as a PDF. So the best thing you can do is to use the shortcut called Windows Shift S. When you use that combination, you would be able to get this snip tool. And you can always snip the portion that you want to save for future. And you can always paste it onto any PowerPoint slide. So you would be able to refer to your old rehearsal reports. We have a treat for you in a separate video called How to Turn Your Word Document to Visual PowerPoint Slides in One Click with the new AI tool. If you are regularly tasked with the requirement of converting your official documents into presentation slides of some sort, then this can be a useful tool. The link to this useful video is available right here. So click here and learn this interesting option.